Hello everyone, welcome to Digital Academy. I'm Juan Diego Álvarez, your teacher of Spanish. In this lesson, we're gonna learn the introduction to Spanish. First, we're gonna learn to pronunciate correctly the Spanish, and we're gonna learn when to put tildes in English accent. It's very easy, so let's start. In Spanish,
words are pronounced the same way they were reading.
Let's start with vowels. Vowels are very easy to pronounce. For example, here we see A, E, I, O, U. Always, in all words, are pronounced like that. It's very easy. Now, we will see examples how to pronounce it. Agua, so water. Ventilador, ventilator, mesero, waiter, cocina, kitchen, queso, cheese. Okay, here in the word queso, we see a U with a E that sounds like E, queso. Okay, when you see this combination, the U with E always is E, an exception if the word have 2 points over the U. For example, in this word, bilingüe. Yes, here we see that you have 2 points over the U. That's the reason why don't sound bilingue, just sounds bilingüe. Celular, cell phone, baño, bathroom. In the word baño, we see a letter that is not used in English, the letter ñ. So it's like ña, ñe, ñi, ño, ñu. Baño. Other example with ñ is niña. Like a girl, but a girl very small.
We use in Spanish letter double L with our pronunciation.
It sounds like j, ya, ye, ji, yo, yu. In example is llanura. In English is plain.
Other letter that is not used in English is double R.
For example, correr. Here we see a double R, like a R but much stronger. Correr. Run. English have something good. In English, you don't have to use accent.
In Spanish, we have to use tildes.
Even for Latin and from all people that speak Spanish, the use of tilde is something difficult for us because there are many rules, grammatics, that tell us when we have to use tildes, but not these rules are able for all these kinds of rules. There are some exceptions. However, Microsoft Word have an automatic correction of spells. Even there are other robots in Google that correct automatically the use of tildes. Even they in WhatsApp automatic corrector. If you are learning Spanish to be a
professional translator,
you have to have a perfectly use of tildes. If you are learning Spanish just to talk with your friend or to travel, you don't have to learn perfectly grammar with tildes. Yes, it's okay. Even you can read perfectly Spanish without tilde. It's okay. So now, let's start.
To learn when we have to put accent over the words, first we need to know the classification of the words. First, we will see the words agudas. Words agudas are those with the accent, the intensity of the voice in the last syllable. That it means here, the last syllable. See? It is important to note that not all agudas words have a strong accent, or in Spanish, tilde. That is, here we see certain examples. Peru have the accent in last syllable. Sofa, café, Rubí, menú, bebé. There are some words agudas that have not a tilde, despite not ending in a vowel. Agudas words have a tilde if end in N or is. For example, también, algún, jamás, según, sillón, además, organización, capitán, alemán, canción. But there are some agudas words without accent. For example, amor, papel, reloj, pared, avestruz. In the case of agudas words in which a strong vowel is found with a weak accented one, the letter would carry an accent tilde. For example, maíz, paul, Raúl, baúl. ¿Sí? In English, his name is Paul, but in Spanish is Paul. Now, these are the graves words. The graves words have an intensity of the voice in the penultimate syllable here. Graves words don't have an accent if end in a vocal or N or is. For example, árbol, cárcel, ángel, difícil, túnel, azúcar, lápiz, césped, útil. But also there are graves words without an accent. For example, problema, adulto, martes, zapatos, pesca, taza, piso. For example, the word corazón has an accent when it is a singular because intensity of the voice is in the last syllable and end in N. And when it becomes plural, the intensity of the voice goes to the penultimate syllable, and since it ends in is, it no longer carries accent mark. Heart, corazón, is an aguda word. Hearts, in plural, corazones, is a grave word. Some other examples of words with the same shape are organización, in singular, and in plural, organizaciones. Here, does not have tilde. ¿Sí? Nación, have tilde, but naciones do not have tilde. Objeción, objeciones. Declaración, declaraciones. Explicación, explicaciones. Guión, guiones. There are some graves words accentuated in the ending ia. For example, María, antropología, biología, oftalmología. All the graves words ending in two vowels, followed by or by N or is, bear a tilde. When the first of this vowel is weak, E or U, and the pronunciation is lot on int. Example, moría, dead, policía, actúes. These are examples. Words that end in eo or io do not have accent. For example, mareo, patio, paseo. This kind of words does not have accent. The words esdrújulas are those that carry the intensity of the voice in the penultimate syllable. It is very important to note that in this case, all the words are always accented with an accent. Example, America. This is the penultimate syllable. America, Bélgica, Sudáfrica, música, miércoles, sílaba, máquina, gramática, económico, pájaro, séptimo, cuídate, brújula, gótico, hígado, ejército, características, cállate, dámelo, fósforo, cáscara, cerámica, oxígeno, didáctico, válido. The words sobre esdrújulas are those that carry the intensity of the voice in the last syllable before the third to last syllable. They are of an accent. These sobre esdrújulas words that carry accent are generally verbs that are attached to indirected and directed complements or are adverbs. Example of sobre esdrújulas words, cuéntamelo. This is the syllable before the third to last syllable. ¿Sí? Cuéntamelo, devuélveselo, éticamente, fácilmente, explícaselo, rápidamente, juégatela, véndemelo, repíteselo, frívolamente, ágilmente, ábremelo, dígaselo, cálidamente, difícilmente, dibújamelo, dócilmente, gánatela. Accent rules. To know where and when to play the Spain accent, these are the rules. Words that end in a weak vowel, such as E or U, followed by a two vowels together and a final is, carry a tilde in the weak vowel if the force of pronunciations fall on it. Example, seríais, daríais. So these kind of words with eis are only used in Spanish from Europa, Spanish of Spain. In America Latina, we don't use this kind of verbs. But in the case that you will write these words, always have a tilde here. Okay, when a simple word becomes part of a compound as its first complement, it will be written without an orthographic accent that would have corresponded as simple. For example, inútil have a accent, yes, but inutilizar does not have accent. Even this word is very similar, have a very similar mean, but here do not have a tilde because now this word is a little bit much longer, so the strong accent change. Exception, compounds ending in mente. See, there are many words in Spanish that finish in mente. This kind of words have a tilde usually. For example, fríamente, coldly, cortésmente. See, three, agudas words ending in I, A, oi, ui are written without an accent. For example, Paraguay, buey. Monosyllables are only marked to differentiate them grammatically and functionally when there are single syllable words that depend on the tilde for different meanings. The accent used to make this distinction is called the critical accent. For example, el is the article de in English, see? Does not have accent here. But here it got accent because el with accent mark, it means he in English, like a pronoun. But here is article. Tú is your, does not have accent mark. But here, tú, as you, does have an accent. De of does not have accent, but de with accent mark is mean like you give does have accent mark. Más, however, does not have accent mark, but más with accent mark have other mean, is like more. When the conjugation resulting words is drúculas or sobre drúcula, it is necessary to take them. For example, pidiendo, ¿sí? Pidiéndoles, ¿sí? Here got a accent mark. Suprime, suprímelo. So this is all the video. I hope you all have understood it, the explaining. It's very easy, just see the video many times if you think that you need it. So this is our introduction to Spanish. You never think that it's difficult to learn this language. It's very easy. Now it's the second language most learned in the world. And always think in your mind, I can, I'm able, and I will get it. I will learn to speak Spanish perfectly.
I love you.